So, day two of AirVenture by EAA in Oshkosh. Hilton, all-you-can-eat buffet. I believe it's $13, and that's where I'm headed on this beautiful morning, Tuesday, July 24th. All right, gonna have some breakfast. See you guys in a bit. Breakfast was delicious at the Hilton. And then they have an observation deck looking over the field. You can watch planes take off, land. And this is the South 40. The other side of the field where I'm at. All right, see you in a bit. So if you come to Oshkosh, the EAA fly-in, you have to check out the seaplane base. We're going this way. It's a pretty cool walk to the seaplane base. It's a $3 round trip for the bus to get you here. Definitely well worth checking out. All right, we're gonna keep walking. See you guys in a bit. All right, folks, well, here we are. Welcome to EAA AirVenture Oshkosh Seaplane Base. Okay, quick view of everything. Tons of things to do here.
And this is better. It's a 7-seat airplane with dual control.
That thing is better. Guys, I'm gonna walk around a little bit and I'll get right back to you. See you in a bit. Thank you. waiting for that boat to pass out there. We are still at the EAA float plane base. Seaplane, courtesy of the pilot. So this should be fun. A lot of seaplanes coming in. That's a pretty cool one. Volunteer?
Yeah.
Well, thank you for volunteering. Appreciate
yeah,
it.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a joy to be here.
Without you guys, this wouldn't happen, unfortunately.
It's a joy to be here. Take vacation to come to this.
Awesome. And here's the seaplane pulling up for me. pretty cool, right?
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Awesome. Easiest thing.
Awesome, thank you. You must like doing this.
So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to bring it around. I'm going to try to drop you on the right side now that we got regular help.
Okay.
Well, that guy's not even started. Christopher Lee, there you go.
See, plane flight. Thanks again. Hey guys, so we're at the float plane base in EAA's property here, and that was my first flight flying in a float plane, and what a crazy experience that was. It just looks so odd to me as you're landing in the water, because typically we don't do that, and it was just weird how the landed on the water like it was runway. And the floats worked perfectly, and it was an amazing experience. So if anybody out there has an opportunity to fly in a float plane, definitely take advantage of it. Float plane, seaplane. Take the opportunity to do it, because it's an amazing experience, and you will like it. So I have some planes behind me I'm going to show you. A little different than, I was in a 172 with floats on it. And these are planes that are pretty much made just for water, but they also have gear, so you could also taxi on the ground as well. So this is where those planes would taxi up through here. And these planes are two planes, floats. The gear do go up. So something pretty cool to look at. So if you are like sea and like land, something like this would be pretty practical. But then again, you can also get floats on a 172 and other aircrafts that you can put gear on if you had to. So here's a pretty cool plane. How's it going? And then they come up on that little ramp there and they park right over here. So there you have it. Until next time, I'll see you guys in a bit. We'll walk around a little more. All right, folks.
Was that Mike's over at the other?
to boat here, checking out the seaplane base on the water.
I'll give you a little history of this.
This guy's talking.
This is all private property right here, owned by the Betty family, John Betty. He's actually 80 years old. He was out here last night, and he allows the EAA to use this area once a year. But come next Monday, everything has to be cleaned up and returned to a natural area.
Talk about the docks, the buoys, everything.
Yeah.
Take it all out.
A lot of the stuff on land, same thing. But their family has owned this. It's transferred ownership amongst the family a little bit. But this area was an old sawmill in the 1800s, a big transportation area for lumber, pickup and delivery. So he uses this, basically keeps it in the family. He still owns that barn, and there's a house on the other side of that.
And there, also, there's an airstrip right beside that.
Yep.
In case you'll see an airplane parked right there.
So he's pretty passionate about keeping this going.
And these airplanes, I can tell you, that one straight ahead is a J3 Cub. It's kind of the granddaddy of all Cubs. Started making them probably early 30s. Started out with a 40-horse engine, I think. Most of them have a 65 or 80.
So that's basically the float plane base here at Oshkosh. We're going to head back to the big airport. Hope you guys had a good time here. Great place to check out. And here it all is in a nutshell. See you in a bit. So you guys know how much I love my Mooney M20C Ranger 1968. Take a look at this Mooney Ovation Ultra. Brand new. Smells brand new. Cool. Awesome panel. And of course, new Moonies have two doors to them finally, except for that one. Mooney is still putting in the roll cages. That's a roll cage for Mooney. My plane has that. well known for safety, reliability, and stability. All right, see you in a bit. Hey guys, so here we are on top of the VIP Mooney tent. Take a look. Pretty good views from up here. That's Hangar D, like many hangars. Hangar B's over there. Alrighty, there you go. See you guys in a bit. Hey guys, well, it is Tuesday evening and air show about to begin. Let's take a look. Wi-Fi jet. Show. by two by two by two. Perfect landing, coming in perfect.
We're gonna miss it.
Gas undercarriage mixture prop, seatbelt speed. I don't think they use that checklist, but.
Oh my god, take video. I'm missing this video.
Check out some light sports that are landing and taking off over in the light sports section. Let's check it out. Taking off. NCAA Light Sports. Coming in like crazy.
I mean, so the owner is Brett Ball. He's beating his grandson,
C-41A looks like. They used to use these as airliners back in the day, in the 40s, 50s, and even 60s. Carrying people around the country. It's a lot of history. That is a pretty cool plane. There you go, another example of Oshkosh, what kind of planes they bring here. And I'm gonna keep looking for some fun stuff. Alright. Here's another interesting plane that they use for the military and civil. Lands on the water and lands on land. Use this in the military, and they also use this for regular civilian transportation. Short hops, extra fuel tank. And you have floats on both ends, and the gear would actually go up into the body when you're landing on water. Inside, pretty standard. And over here, and I was telling you guys before how the airliners used to use these type of planes in the 40s, 50s to transport passengers. And here is an example of an old airline called Western Airlines. AirVenture here at Oshkosh has tons and tons of aircrafts, actually thousands of aircrafts, all different kinds of shapes, sizes, makes, and models. Another great example of a great plane, military plane. In the military, back in the heyday, and they still do it today to an extent, they would name their aircrafts. Military guys would actually do their own painting, and even would paint the bombs and the bombers back in the day, and some other names that I don't want to discuss on the channel. But there you have it. Another awesome plane here at AirVenture in Oshkosh. All right, let's keep looking. So perfect timing to see some Light Sports take off here at the Light Sport taxiway and runway. They're all coming in. Oh, and you all also find some odd vehicles here at Oshkosh. Here's one right here. Alright, back to the plane. Short field takeoff since the other end of the runway, so we'll go get down there in time. Okay guys, thanks for watching day two of AirVenture in Oshkosh. You just saw for the last 5 minutes or so the ultralights and the light sports landing. This is their landing strip that they use every year. And they also use RV remote control aircrafts in this area as well for nighttime and other different flights of the day. Talk to you soon.